Okay, next is effect of doping. So because of the addition of impurity, an additional energy level called donor level is introduced, which is closer to the conduction band. As you can see from the diagram, this is your donor level. Okay. Why it happens? Let's say again, it happens in N type of semiconductor. So in N type of semiconductor, we have added a pentavalent impurity. So this impurity had 5 valence electrons, and 4 of those valence electrons will form bonds with silicon atoms, and 1 is very loosely bound to the nucleus. So when small amount of energy will be produced, since it is loosely bound to the nucleus, its energy will be higher. Okay, so that's why its energy will be close to conduction band. When a small amount of energy will be applied or heat will be applied, it will move from here to conduction band. Okay, and why only it is represented by a single line? Because the number of impurities are actually very less than the number of silicon atoms. Because of the valence electrons of silicon atoms, a band of conduction and valence we are getting formed. No, but due to presence of impurity, this donor level is getting formed. And we know if there are 10 raised to power 6 silicon atoms, only one phosphorus atom is present. Hence, it is represented by a line. So this will be your donor level. Okay, and it will be very close to the conduction band, such that energy difference is 0.01 electron volts. Next is for p-type semiconductors. Now, because of introduction of impurity in p-type semiconductor like boron, okay, here also an energy level is introduced, okay, and that is also known as acceptor level. Acceptor energy level, it will be again represented by a single line, okay, and it will be closer to the valence band. Okay. So in p-type semiconductors, to move the electrons from here to here, you will have to supply larger amount of energy compared to n-type semiconductors. Okay. So at room temperature, most of these acceptor atoms get ionized, leaving holes in the valence band. Means when there is a room temperature, no, the electrons which are present here, okay, because energy difference between acceptor level and valence band is very less, 0.01 to 0.05 electron volts. So electrons which are in valence band at room temperature, they will move from here to here. Okay, so most of the electrons will be in acceptor level. Okay. Thus, at the room temperature, density of holes is predominantly due to impurity in the extrinsic semiconductor. Now, we have learned that in p-type semiconductor, majority is hole, and the density of hole is basically due to impurity. Next is the electron and hole concentration in a semiconductor in thermal equilibrium is given by Ne into NH is equals to Ni square, where Ne is electron density, NH is density of holes, is equals to Ni whole square. Ni is density of charge carriers in intrinsic semiconductors. Okay. That's all. Thank you.